Well, good evening, everyone. Welcome to the webinar this evening, Preparing Your Friesian Horse for the Inspection, Part 1, sponsored by the Fenway Foundation for Friesian Horses. This is the first part of a 5-part series being put on by Petra Zeelen and Doeke Hoekstra. This session will focus on clipping your Friesian for the inspections and winter training. We are recording this section and we will post to our Fauna YouTube session tomorrow. We are also live on Facebook. If you have a friend who can't get in, please refer them to the Facebook page. We do encourage questions and we will stop periodically and answer your questions. To submit your questions down at the bottom of your screen, just click on the Q&A and we will stop periodically and ask your questions. We want to thank the Fauna Education Committee for providing this excellent education opportunity. I'd now like to introduce two people all the way from Zurich, Friesland, where it is 1 o'clock in the morning. So I'd like to introduce Petra Zeelen and Doeke Hoekstra. Petra, are you with us?
Yes, I am.
Okay.
Doeke is here as well, but he's on the sideline.
Okay, terrific, terrific. So let me stop sharing my screen here. Okay, Doeke, or Petra, if you would just across the bottom, click on the share screen.
It's not doing anything. Yeah, come on. There it is. I had to do it over.
There we go. So periodically throughout this webinar, we are showing video clips. And we have, sometimes those video clips don't always come across on each computer clearly. So it's really up to your internet speed on whether or not those videos come through clearly. Some of them may be just a little bit interrupted. They may jig just a little bit. You may miss a step of the horse. May miss part of the clipping procedures that Petra goes over, but just bear with us. We're doing the best we can. And remember that we're conducting this webinar with someone who's 5,000 miles away from us right now. So again, yeah. Petra, thank you guys for being here. We appreciate it and look forward to your presentation this evening.
Well, thank you. Thank you for having me. And you're right, I know things about horses, but I don't know anything about computers. So up until an hour ago, we were still figuring out how to get it to work. So I'm gonna start with a little video about how I prepare the horse before I start clipping. The videos I'm gonna show are all about clipping, and I will try to show what we do when we clip the Friesian for the curring as a preparation. And I try to show the things that people ask me most about. So if people think that I missed something, please send Jason your question and I will try to answer it. And even for the coming up videos, send in questions ahead of time and I will try to answer them while I do my presentation, the upcoming part of this video presentation. So today it's just clipping and I'm gonna start with a little video just about how I prepare. Okay, I hope it's gonna work. So this is preparing your Friesian, my preparation for clipping. This is the horse that we're clipping today. This horse just had a baby and we took her in and you can see that she still has all the hair. And this is in the winter, so she has her winter coat as well. I'm gonna try and show you everything. So even the mock she has, and we wanna clip and clean that as well. So that's why I'm showing that as well. There it is, the foot clean. I sped it up because it took a lot of time making the videos, and we had so much material that these parts I just sped up. It's just soaping, cleaning, making sure the coat is very clean. Make sure that you know where the mock of the Friesian is, so it's nice and clean and dry when you start flipping. I make sure that the legs are really clean because you don't want to use your nice sharp clippers on hair that has sand in it. Then after the washing, I spray them with shine spray to make sure that the next day I do the clipping, that it's still nice and clean and soft and the hair fall out easily. So that was just a little preparation. I will go to the next video of clipping the face. I hope it opens right there. Start. Oh, wait. That was not the right one. One second, because something went. Yes, there it is. So we couldn't get these videos storaged on my computer. Clipping the face and ears. There's a preparation for that as well. I make sure that the mane and the forelock are away from the face so that not by accident, if the horse moves, that your clipper ends up in the hairs or in the forelock or in the mane and you cut out a big piece. So this is how the mare looks with the hair in the ears and hairy face and everything. Okay, I'm trying to get her to get used to the clippers. And then I'm looking for the spot on the face where the hair is the shortest. And I turn around my clippers and I put it on her face and I just gently stroke it along her cheek. And as you can see, we almost go up onto the skin. And all that hair comes off. Now you see that the horse is a little bit brown underneath. That usually happens in the winter. So for at this time, this is not a problem. If you know your horse is brown underneath, then you use a longer knife to make sure that you don't cut it that short. What we do a lot of the time is that when a horse comes in for training, and after a week, we kind of do like a test clipping to make sure that we know what color is underneath. And especially at the end of the summer, in the autumn or in the spring, some dense fur is still underneath and that sometimes has a little brown color. And if you clip it too short, it turns brown. I did this on purpose so I can show you what happens if you do it that way. In the summer, this usually is not a problem. They are all nice and black underneath, but we do a test clipping when they come in to make sure that we know if they stay black when we clip them this short. I did get some questions ahead of time. They will be answered, I hope, through this video. And if people think that they need some more explanation, please send in the question to Jason. And there will be some pieces that I will speed up again, just
to keep it going a little bit, if that's okay with you, Jason.
Yes, yes. Quick question that just came in is a member wants to know what size clipper blades you are currently using.
This was a 10. I usually use 10 and 15. I believe 10 is a little bit longer than 15, or the other way around, but I use the one that, so, oh, there it goes. I use 10 or 15, and the one that is a little bit longer, I always use that one on the face or the legs. And then in the summer, I use the shorter one on the ears. Now you see something happened in my screen. And now, yes, there it is. That was a little bit of a panic moment because I don't know what to do. I know what to do when a horse stops, but not when my computer stops.
Well, that's what Doeke is there for.
So as you can see, I completely make the underside of the head ball as short as possible. I think you can see the clipper blade, what the one is I'm using right here. But now, in the Netherlands, and actually in the EU, there is a new rule that we are new, it's not that new, that we are not allowed to clip whiskers and the lashes. I don't, the one, the long hairs around the eyes. Now it is a rule in Europe. It's not a rule in the United States yet, I think. The judges prefer to see them long, because that's just what we have to do over here, just as the hair in the ears. Okay, I'm gonna go over to the head again. As you can see, I completely have all the hair off the face right now, not the whisker, but as you can see, the whole neck and throat opens up. And you can see how different this already looks. Even with her winter coat, it looks better. This is where I show you the whiskers, and we just have to leave them on. So it's advice the KFPS gives you, but you don't have to obey them with the whiskers and the ears, and the because it's not a breeding standard for the Friesian. They could change that in the future, but it isn't yet. So you're still allowed to clip them, but they prefer to see them like we have them in the Netherlands, so long. So this was the face. I'm gonna go over to the ears next. There you go. The outside of the ears, I also take the long hairs off. It just makes them look a little bit nicer. Then I take my fingers through the ear, and I'll show you the way we clip them to make them look really nice and sharp without taking the hairs out. So I'm taking off the outer edge completely, but I leave on that little tip on the top of the ear because I really like it. A lot of people don't take the time to leave it and they just take everything off, but I like that little tip. It gives the Friesian a little bit extra, and especially when they have those nice ears pointing together. Okay, now you can see that when I squeeze the ear, there's nothing sticking out anymore, but there's still hair in there, and that's what the judges like to see. And as you can see, I never know when to stop clipping. There's always some hair that I find that needs to come off. Within the rules, of course. And the outside is nice and tight. And if you can see, you can see in the background the other ear. And this one just looks really nice and smooth if you do the outside too.
A question for you, Petra, is how far in advance of the inspections do you actually do your clipping?
Me personally, because I did that pre-clipping when the horse came in, or I know my horses, I do it a day, maybe 2 days ahead of time. I know that in some stables, they do it like at the beginning of the week if the judging is on Saturday. So they do it on Monday or Tuesday, but I prefer when the judging is on Saturday, I do it on Friday and I wash them as well. So I do the clipping and the washing a day ahead of time. But I know some people even have a week in between. But I like my horses really clean. So I prefer to do it a day before the curring.
Okay.
Now, I know that's more difficult in the US because of the traveling. So there's the other ear. I sped it up a little bit. And you can see right there the way I put my clippers against the ear. That makes it that I don't end up inside the ear. There you go. And right there. You see, the hair is still in because I know somebody asked me about, there was a question about, I've got it right here. I see pictures where it looks like the entire inside and outside is trimmed. Well, the outside is trimmed, but not bald. I leave the hair on. And other looks like it's just the inner. So in a second, it will show you what happens if you clip them like this, and then you put oil in your ear, and it looks clean clipped. You see? There's a very big difference now between the two. The one with my hand has oil in it, and just when the light hits the hair, you can see it, but when you see them in pictures, you don't see any hair in that ear anymore. And this is the end result. Same horse. And I think that is a nice cleanup. Okay. This was this video. So if anybody has any questions about clipping the face or, there's one thing I almost forgot. You can see my cursor on the, or my mouse on the screen?
Yes.
Okay, so the pole, I don't clip it anymore. So in the past I did, if a Friesian has a lot of mane and you want to have them loose, and it looks like they don't have a neck. So in the past, what I did, I clipped away a little bit more hair, like up until here, and that opens up this area nicely. We're not allowed to do that anymore. We're only allowed to do a width of 2 fingers right on the spot where your halter or your bridle is. So we're not allowed for judging to clip away any more hair than just the width of a halter or just 2 fingers. So that's a rule that they made for that. So I almost forgot that one, but I don't clip that part anymore because I found that without, I don't know exactly how to explain. So each time when you clip, you take away a little bit more than the time before. So it ends up longer and longer and longer and longer. And then when you try to grow it back, you have a horse with a mohawk. And that doesn't look very pretty when you go into the show ring. So that's why I stopped doing that. Okay.
A couple of questions here that have come in.
Yes.
Is, did you also clip down the front of the face or was it short enough?
No. That's the result of the cleaning I did the day before. So she does have longer hairs here. I didn't clip them. Sometimes I do. It depends on how the face of the horse is, or like my stallion, I had him on a higher level dressage. And in the winter, when it's cold and they start sweating, it gets really wet. And then on the front of the head, it stays cold, and we go back home in a trailer and the wind comes in the trailer. So that's when I completely clip the whole face. For this horse, I didn't do that. And normally for currings, we don't do that. But for a stallion show in the winter, when you know the horse has a black coat, we do a total body clip if the horse needs it. If we know the horse is brownish underneath, we do body clip them as well, and the face, but we do that about 4 weeks ahead of time.
Okay. And if you're using oils, what kind of oil would you recommend?
I recommend the baby oil, because it's good enough to put on your baby. So it's for sure good enough to put it on the face of your horse or the body of your horse.
Okay. And do you use sunscreen if your horse's hair turns brown in the summer?
No. What happens over here is that you bring them to a stable for preparation, and what they do is they turn out your horse each day just for a little bit, maybe half an hour, and the rest of the day they're going they're going to be trained, or they're going into a hot walker. So 2 or 3 times a day they go out, but they don't stay out in the sun. That's very important. And then over time, if they were out in the sun, because of the training and the brushing and the washing and the hosing off and the renewing of the coat, they will turn black again before they go to the curring.
And the last question I've got right now, is it allowed to trim the whiskers and eyelashes a tiny bit with scissors to even them up without clipping?
Officially, no. But if you leave them as long as possible, I don't see the problem, but I'm not the judge. And for sure, in the United States, you have your own rules. And these rules are not, how do you say it? They cannot be forced on you, because it's not a racial type rule that is held by the KFPS. They could do that in the future, but it's not yet. But we have to comply to that rule, because it's a European rule that we're not allowed to clip them at all. But of course, when they look ugly, we just take the little dead ends off and make it look nice as well.
Great, great. That was all the questions I had for that section. Remind our viewers on Facebook that if you do have a question, just type it in the comment section, and we'll be sure to get your questions answered as well. So, Petra, if you want to move on to your next section?
Yes, I'm trying.
Oh, okay.
I'm trying to get there. There you are. I hope this is, yes, this is the right one. I have to make it.
And I will say from my perspective, the videos are playing fantastic.
Okay, that's good to hear. Okay, this is me and my materials. Before you start your clipping, I always make sure that my knives are sharpened, that they're all charged, that I have my oils and my cool care. I bring that in from the US, by the way, because we don't have a brand that works that well. So when I'm in the US, I bring back that. So that's your preparation for the clipping as well. Make sure that you have everything there, and spare knives for the clipping as well. This one is about the legs. I'm going to start with the front leg. And as you can see, I'm going to start on the inside upper front left leg. I'm going to clip with the hair. I have the longer blade, so not the shortest one. And I just go with the hairs and I take all the hairs off that just stick out and make it smooth. So this is one way of clipping. I'm gonna show you multiple ways of clipping the horse. This is just a standard quick clip that we do just to maintain them. This is something you do every month. Or if you don't want to get a lot of hair off the legs of your horse, this would be what you would do for the turn. This is also smoothing out the legs. Right here, I'm doing the tendon on the back. You can already see the difference between the two. I'm taking away the hairs all the way to the bottom of the tendon. You can see me squeezing the tendon all the time and checking where the bottom is of the tendon. And now I'm pointing in the direction that I want the hair to stay. So in the middle of the tendon in the back, I keep it a little bit higher than the rest. So it has a natural way of flowing. So it doesn't look like it's a blunt cut. Some people just put the razor blade on it, pull it down, and it's straight blunt cut, and actually a little bit too low. And sometimes it even looks like a blown out tendon, but that's because that hair on the back of the tendon grows back in a couple of days. So if you do this in the beginning of the week and it grows back, then it looks really weird when you're at the show. And that's when a judge can say, hey, that doesn't look right. And you're going to be judged on the quality of your leg. So it really has to look smooth. Now, I know that a lot of people don't like to clip away the hairs, but for us, it's a way to show the judges that the horses have nice clean legs. You see me squeezing the tendon, and then on the back of the leg, yep, right there, that's more than that. I want to keep that. And from there on, you can see the angle, so it looks naturally. There you go. Oh. Trying to decide on what way we're going to film it. Okay. Now, this is a big difference in these two legs. A really big difference. And this was just a tendon. That's all I did. Now, the next step is to clean up. I think this is the long pastern. Is that how you... Cannon, the long cannon and the short cannon. I just had to check my paper. So the long cannon, and you can see from the two next to each other that when you clip it, it looks longer and cleaner. And that's what you want to show the judges. Now I'm checking this leg for muck and the spur. Depending on how it looks like, you can pull it off or cut it off or ask your farrier to take care of it. Now, right there, you see some muck. I want to know where it is and if it's dry or wet, because the horse can, if you go there with the clippers, it can irritate and it can lift the leg suddenly or kick out when it's the hind leg or something. So that's why I make sure that I know exactly where all the little spots are. And that's why I cleaned the horse the day before too. So I put some iodine or iodium on it to dry it out, to make sure that it's dry and clean, and I take off the little crusts. Okay, right there. I'm showing you by pulling back the hairs, the difference between the two legs. If you clean out the short cannon with clipping as well. And the cannon just looks a little longer and cleaner. And again, the judges like to see clean legs. And the legs are hard to judge when all that hair is there. Now you don't have to do it. It's just that, you can show off that they're actually very clean if the hair is just a little bit clipped away. Now for sports, I do take off this hair as well. I have to check the coronary band. Is it? Well, the hair just above the hook. But for the curring, you don't want to do that because the judges like to see hair, but they like to see clean legs too. Now that's why I wanted to know if there was muck. I'm cleaning out underneath the fetlock. This is something that we almost do all the time, just to make sure that it's always clean or easy to clean or easy to treat. And I could stop and just leave it like this, and you wouldn't see that I took away hair. But I want to clean it up a little bit more, just to open it up a little bit, so I can show off that part of the leg a little bit more. Anyone who has any questions about this. And this is all personal choice, so you don't have to, but I know that if you show the judge this leg, it's easier to judge for them. Instead of the one with all the hair still on it. And usually the hair starts to be curly and it's hard to judge the bone structure underneath. I hope the clippers are not too loud and people can still hear me.
Your volume is just fine, Petra.
Okay.
Everything's good.
So this is just something I wanted to show a little bit more extensively. Now you can see it's a winter coat. And right there, I had to fix a little mess up because I stabbed my clippers in there, and then you have to fix it. I took off a little bit too much.
So Petra, what brand of clippers are you using?
These are actually clippers from the United States. And I can't remember the brand. I have to go back and check that little part of the video that we showed.
Yeah, no worries. No worries. Vicky, we'll get you that answer here shortly.
So now you can see already how clean, and see the difference. Okay. There you go. And now it opened up underneath there as well. I'm not satisfied, so I'm going in again. I'm just talking about, we were just talking about if we should lift up the foot and clean it out that way, but the horse is a little bit heavy, so she likes to lean on you, so I didn't want to do that because it's, when you're working with clippers and the horse starts to lean, then, you have to let go of your clippers, and those are expensive. And you don't want to do that. Okay.
now I'm showing what happens if you take off this hair, and there's a huge difference in size of hoof. And this is another picture of me that I took off and cleaned out the whole part above the hoof. That was another horse I did.
Lay down. Gotta lay down, Bob.
And this is just for showing the difference between the two dogs, and it's a huge difference. And this is sometimes where you get the, I don't know exactly how to say, misperception about a classical Friesian and a modern Friesian. Sometimes it's just the clipping. Okay, I'm gonna go to the next video. So that was just one leg, and then there's another way of clipping the other front leg. I made multiple videos just to be able to show you what we do. There we go. So you see me with the same clipper, and I just start on the top of the leg, and what we do is we go with the hair, and that makes that if the horse is a little bit browner, that the coat stays a little bit blacker, so you don't take it all off. But this also makes the leg look more slender and more clean. And this is usually what we do when we go to shows, not particularly for the current. But if you have an older mare or an older stallion, they usually grow more hair. And we take off more hair. Just to make sure that the leg looks clean. Can you still hear me?
Yeah, we had a little bit of a hearing there when you were coming down the leg, but you turned your volume down on the video, and I think we can hear you just fine now. So
what I was wondering exactly. And I sped up this video a little bit because it's clear that I'm just cleaning off the whole leg, and I'm pointing that angle again to make it look natural. And I want to keep the feathers, so I want to follow that natural curve. Again.
So could you possibly just repeat a little bit about what you just said as you were coming down that leg?
What I said was, this is usually a way of clipping that we do when we go to dressage shows and things like that. But also when your Friesian is getting older, usually the hair gets longer on the legs and more curly. So this is something with the older horses that we do a lot. Okay. Just to make sure that the legs look nice and clean for the curring. Because if we leave it on, well, that just, you know, it covers up the leg too much for the judge to be able to judge it the right way, or not the right way, but to actually see how dry or clean the legs are. It's the same as wearing baggy clothes and wearing nice and tight, slick suit. It's like that. You're still the same person, but you just dress a little bit different.
Gotcha, thank you.
You can see there is just a lot of hair that you just can take off. And again, it's just all going with the hair.
So looking at the clippers, to go back to that question about what type, but those look like Oester, O-E-S-T-E-R clippers, yes, that you get, yes, here in the States.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, now we're at the back side again. And as you can see, this takes a lot more time to get it clean, clipped, as the other leg, because that was just the backside and the short cannon. So this is me speeding it up. I'm not doing it right now, but I did it in the, because it took a long time to get it all smooth. And now you can see that over here, the hair is just a little bit gray. So if you flip the horse and you rinse it off afterwards, it's completely black again. So I never clip after washing for current prep. I make sure my horse is clean. So I do kind of like a pre-wash, just to make sure that the sand and all the stuff is out. And then just make sure that my clippers don't wear too much because of it. And checking again. Now I'm checking out the height, kind of, just to make sure that they're equal, the same height of the feathers. Or something has to come off on the right front leg. And if you look at this pattern in the hair, that's my mistake. It's all about the speed you take down your clippers on the coat and the speed the clippers are moving. So if you pull down your clippers too fast, this is the pattern you get in the coat of your horse. So I had to go a little slower to make it look better, but that's okay. Mistakes are made to learn from, so next time. So if you start clipping and it's your first time to do it like this, make sure that you already start practicing, just to make sure that you know how your clipper works with the hair of that horse. The clipper never works the same on each horse, so that's important to know too.
Oh, no.
So as you can see, I'm pointing out that edge and I'm cleaning off this way more than on the other one, just to make it look cleaner and more modern again. So this is sometimes what I see come by on Facebook on modern Friesian and a classical Friesian, but sometimes I know the Friesians in the picture and I know which horses they are, and I know that one of them is without being clipped. And the same horse being clipped doesn't look like that same horse. So In upcoming videos, I can show you one or two horses that are look completely different before and after clipping. And then you have like the Baroque type and the modern type, but it's the same horse. It's just all about how much hair you leave on when you clip it. So it's just what your personal preference is.
Okay. De achterkant moet, zeg ik mok, maar dat is misschien wel goed om een beeld te zetten.
There we go. This is a front leg with a little bit more painful, like a wet spot, I believe. So I'm trying to find that before I put my clippers in there. I think the reason I want to show this also, the mop, I could have chosen another horse that doesn't have it at all, but that wouldn't be an honest picture of what we have to deal with every now and then. So I wanted to show this as well. It's not just for the curling, but this is what we do to be able to treat the moss really well as well. And as you can see, there's a little wet spot, and I treated it a couple of days and it was gone. So just clipping it and make sure that it stays clean is very important.
So Petra, a question for you is, would you change how you clip if the shorter hair draws attention to a less desirable trait or fault?
Say that again.
Would you change how you clip if the shorter hair draws attention to a less desirable trait or fault?
No, I would just clip it like this. But if you don't clip it at all, I mean, it, if you change something in your clipping, it pays attention. You see that as well. So you just have to clip the same way the whole leg. I mean, you, the judges will see it anyway. So you just choose for that way of clipping. And if you change something on one leg and not on the other one, that's weird. So I always clip in the same way.
But so it does not matter the horse, the pedigree of the horse or anything. You're going to clip the horse exactly the same regardless.
Yes, because I know that at the moment, the preference is to have a little bit more of a modern horse. So it helps to clean the legs more than it was before. So this part, the judges really like to see that left on. They don't like it if you take that off. So I leave this on, but when I go into the arena for dressage, I take everything off. That's just my personal preference. And so I take this all off, but I do really love the feathers. So I leave as much of the feathers on as I can, but the rest of the leg, I take all the hair off. But this I leave on for the curring. I just want to show off the length of the leg with clipping. And as you can see, you can already see the difference between the completely clipped leg and the other one. So this one just looks tighter than that one. What I do for the curring is that I fluff up the feathers a little bit. I brush them upwards instead of downwards. But everybody does it their own way. Some people even take a oily rag and just squeeze it all together and have it shiny instead of fluffy. That's all personal. And usually, you know, the judges see everything. So it's hard to cover up things.
That is very true. They do see everything.
Yes. So I just like a clean horse. And that's what I go for when I clip them. Hind legs. Let's see if there's a faster way to do that right there. There you go. I always like to knot up the tail so it's not in my way. And if they step aside or something and you're slipping and you cut into their tail, that's not what you want. And in the winter, you just saw me point at some feathers they have on their buttocks. I clip those off too. There you go. And again, just go with there. And in between the buttocks, the hair is so short that if you put your clippers on it, it doesn't even clip. So you gently stroke it out to take those hairy things off. And I gently go downwards. And make sure that it's clean. And then what I do on the back, because they lay or roll, there's usually more hair on the back of the hock. So I clean that up too. And then I take that tendon, and that's my base for the clippers. I just put it on. And as you can see, I don't go with the hair. I don't have my clippers going like that. I just turn it and just take all the hair off on the back. And in the end, you will see why. It will show off the really nice leg. And this is just blending. This is already a little bit of an experienced mare, so it's easy to sit down behind the mare like this. I wouldn't advise that with any of the young horses. I know that in the US, a lot of the horses are already used to the clippers. People pay a lot of attention and spend a lot of time of getting the horses used to it. We don't have that luxury. We get them when they're three. And sometimes they've never seen a clipper before. And we just have to see how they act. And that's also a reason why I like to do a pre-clipping in the first week they or the second week they're there. Okay, right here, you can see why I took all that hair off, because that tendon is really nice and clean. I just took all the wobbly hair off, so you could really show it off to the judge. See if that turns a little bit so you can see the other leg. It doesn't. All right, there you go. In the background, you can see that it's looks way, the other leg looks way bumpier because of the hair still on there. And again, I just follow the tendon and clean it off. This is usually all I do on a back leg. Just clean out the tendon and clean out the pastern a little bit. And sometimes we have horses who don't like to be clipped on the hind legs at all. And then you just have to leave it. I've never had that in the US yet. They are, almost all of them are very well behaved, but here in the Netherlands, sometimes you can't reach the hind end with the clippers, but that's just because we, you know, we keep them in big groups and they come out when they go to the curling, and then they get broken on the saddle, and that's when their training begins. Okay, this was the one with the mock that was in the first video, and you can see this was 2 or 3 days later, because we clipped on different days. I wanted this to be drier. And now you can see I couldn't just pull out the little scabs, and it's nice and clean. And it was really dirty in the first video I showed you. And this is the same wagon. It just has a little bit of a tiny wet spot right there, but she's not sensitive on it anymore. Now, there was a question I got sent ahead of time about do's or don'ts or do's before you go to the curring, like with shampoo and stuff like that. You're not allowed to use paint on your horse to color the horse. You're not allowed to use extensions. Now, I do know, but I'm not sure if that still is the case. If you have a horse like, if a foal ate the whole tail, then you can call in or send an email to the KFPS and tell them, well, if there's no hair left, I reuse the extensions, but you have to tell them ahead of time so they know that it's not the real hair that's on there. But if they find out later, it never happened, but I know that they don't really appreciate it.
So Petra, would I be penalized if I was trimming the feathers for medical reasons?
No.
Would I need to present a veterinary note?
No. You could present it, but I know that some people just like to trim all the feathers and they show them at the curring as well. It's harder for the judges to judge the racial type. I think it has to do a little bit with racial type, how much feathers are still showing. So I don't think you need to show a medical or a vet letter for that. But you can always ask, of course. If it's due to medical reasons, you can always ask the stumbook if it's necessary to bring a letter from your vet. Now you can see on this leg, the horse had the wet mock, and you can see that the leg is a little bit filled up. So you want to get rid of that mock way before the curring, because you don't want to see the little bit of a filled up, fetlock, because that's something they do really judge. And if there's hair or no hair, they will see it. So that's also a reason to take really good care of the mock.
So I think in a minute, we'll show you the difference between, there we go. That, I think this is a really big difference between the two hind legs. This looks really nice and modern and clean, except for the little fill up of the result of the mock. And you can see how clean it looks compared to the hind leg with all the hair still on there. So this is usually what we do for the current. Now this one is, there you go. Now this one is more sporty clip. I took off more than I would usually do for the current from this hind leg. But that's also due to the mock she had. It had to be done anyway. Well, this is the difference between the two legs when you clean them up. Okay, go to the next one. And I think that's the last one. You have to pick the right one. There you go. Now this is the body clipping. Also preparation, make sure that you braid your horse and have it tightly braid. If you start clipping the neck, you don't wanna take off any of the mane, of course. Almost every winter, I clip my horse at least once, at least the one I train. The advantage is that you don't have to wait for the coat to dry. And you don't have to rinse them. You can get a damp rag to take off the sweat, and you can just put the blanket on when they're cool. So this will be, I'm using the big clipper. Again, I'm going with the hair from the fetlock down. And from there, again, that angle of the fetlock, and I go up all the way up against the hair. I set it up as well, was waiting for me to be done with clipping. And right there, I clean out the underneath the fetlock really well. And I take all the hair up.
So Petra, a question that came up while you were braiding the mane there. Don't mean to go backwards here, but say my horse has itched out some of his mane. Should I still bring him to the inspection?
Yes, of course. Yeah, you can. There are different reasons. So last summer I had a mare whose a part of the mane were chewed off by the foal. So that's not something you can prevent. Then you have, if you braid your mare or horse and the brake gets stuck and the horse pulls it out, that happens a lot too, because more and more people braid the horses and take care of the manes, but sometimes they just snag something and you find the whole braid missing. And if they're rubbing, the judges don't like it if it's rubbing, but it doesn't say anything about the way your horse moves or looks like. It's something they will make a note of and maybe say something about it. But I don't think it will end up being something that it couldn't get a star. What could happen if there are two horses that are equally good and you see one that looks a little bit scruffy because of the rubbing, that would be placed then below the other one that doesn't have any issues at all. That could be a possibility. Or even when your horse looks a little bit brown, and the other one looks completely black and they're equal and everything else, then that would be something to have them difference in the place.
But what if your horse has some of that, what can I do to make my horse look a little darker and get some of those red highlights out of the mane?
I personally like to wash and clean the manes really well. And I do use a lot of detangler just to keep it smooth. It's like with your own hair. If you take care of it really well, or keep it braided, or keep it in the braid bags, they don't turn brown that much in the summer outside. So that would be a good thing. And usually, like when they go to the curring, they've been inside during the day for so many weeks that you usually don't find any brown hairs back into the mane anymore, just because it keeps rotating the hair. But there are different kinds of hair that are softer and that are easier to color. I mean, it colors in the sun and the points do get brown, or just the top layers, and that's, you can't do anything about that. I mean, or cover it with a blanket, like with a sun blanket. We do that more and more over here. They're completely covered from head to toe, just to keep the sun on it. I'll see if I can speed this up just a little bit. So again, I pay a lot of attention to the legs because I just like them nice and clean. So this is what happens when you take all the hair off. And the difference between the two legs again is massive. And this would be the sports look. So this is how I would go to a dressage show. Having them clipped like that. It's easier to put polo wraps on them. It's easier to keep them up clean. It's easier to treat them. It's easier in the winter to, you don't have to hose them down after training because they're almost dry. And I just wanted to show you all the different ways that we do clip them. You don't have to be scared to clip your Friesian just because you think you're not allowed to. You can clip, well, as you can see, the whole horse. And I'm not afraid to turn up with a little bit of a brown undercoat, because in 2 or 3 weeks, this will be black again. For the curring, I wouldn't advise to clip like this, because then, you know, you show up with not a black horse. I would keep the normal coat. But just for going on competition, I prefer it really short like this. This is where I put the saddle pad on, just to see how big of a patch I want to leave on the back. A lot of the times you leave a patch on the back just where the saddle is, because some horses are sensitive in the skin and they don't like the clipped hairs and then the saddle pad on it and the saddle. It rubs them and they get sensitive. It's like when a man has like a day old beard and you rub up against it, that hurts. So as you can see, I keep that patch of hair on there, on this side, and the rest just comes off. Don't forget to oil your clippers, very important.
That's why I put that thing on there, just in case I forgot to tell you.
Now, I will say that oil is a very key ingredient there in the whole thing. I mean,
yes.
From a guy who has very short hair, you know, I don't like to get nicked by those clippers.
Yes. And it helps to have a really clean wash, because before I did the body clipping, I washed the horse again, just to make sure that it's clean, because the horse comes outside every day and it rolls and it plays. I just wanted to make sure that my clipper stays sharp and it doesn't get annoying for the horse. So the cleaner the horse, the easier it is to clip for you and for the horse. Now on the chest, you have all different kinds of directions of hair, and you have to pay attention to actually be able to take off all the hair right there, because it runs in all different directions. 1 second. And then you have the armpits. Very important to pull away the skin. Sometimes it's easier to pull the leg forward and then clip it. As you can see, I braided the whole tail just to make sure that I don't cut off the tail. And on this side, I took off all the hair. I know that I only ride with clean saddle pads. So it usually isn't a problem to clip the whole back and then just ride the horse with a saddle pad. And they don't get sensitive just because you use the clean stuff, and keep your horse really clean, then it doesn't matter that much. But if you have a sensitive horse, I would recommend to keep the hair on the back. So I left, especially for the video, one half on and one half off. So on the left is usually what you leave. But for myself, I don't prefer it. I just like it all cut off. Okay. The neck. 1 second. Now this is usually the most scary part, because you have to cut right next to the mane. And that's why I have a really tight braid in it, so I can determine what is coat and what is mane. And I just take off a little bit more each time. And details again, I clip all the way up there too. And then this is, so a little bit ago you asked me about the face. Now, this is usually where I would clip the face, but with this horse, her hair was still nice and short on her face, so I left it. I just took the clippers and just clipped her cheeks on her, until her, how do you call this bone? The cheekbone. And that's exactly where I stopped. So if you get like an edge of the clippers, your bridle will cover it, or your halter, and they won't see it in a show ring. There you go. So I didn't have to clip the horse because we didn't have a really big winter. Just the last couple of 2 weeks, I especially did a body clip on her to show you guys that it's not a problem to do a body clip on a horse, and what you're able to do with clipping your horse and why Friesians sometimes look so different before and after they go to training. Just because everybody clips in a different way and there are different options to clip a horse. And then later on in a follow-up video, so the next time, then you can see how she looks completely body clipped. Because the moment I was videoing this for body clipping, it was one of the coldest weeks we had in years. So I didn't want to bring her outside in the cold with a complete body clipping to take a picture. It was just too cold. So that will show you the next time that we have the webinar. I will speed it up a little bit. That's the other side. And there you go, finish it up. There you go. And see, when you're up to the neck, as soon as you're starting to clip, have a blanket ready to make sure that the horse doesn't get cold. Or even some people have those nice heaters hanging in the aisles. Put them underneath the heater so they don't get too cold and start shivering, because that's not comfortable for the horse. Well, this was my last video. Don't know if you have any more questions about the clipping.
Right now, I don't have anything in the queue. So this is your opportunity to ask some last minute questions, guys. Been a great webinar. Lots of comments, Petra. Very informative. Appreciate you doing this. I know it's late or early, either way you look at it, for you right now. So I know our membership is really enjoying this. Again, we are recording this, so it will be on our YouTube station. If you've missed anything, got a lot of people are thanking you. Really, really appreciate you taking the time out of your schedule to do this. So just looking at some of the questions here.
So I want to add to this that the way you clip your Friesian is a personal choice. The way I clip the legs, you can take off as much as you want or leave on as much as you want. It is nice for the judges to look at some clean legs because it's easier to judge them. But if you prefer to leave the hair on just because you don't like the horse being clipped, it is harder for the judges to look at the quality of the legs if it's all very fluffy. So that would be a personal choice. You can leave it all on, but I wouldn't recommend it because it looks cleaner and it's easier to judge for the horse, for the judges. But you can, as you could see in the videos, you can clip it in any way you want. You can just show off the tendons in the back, or you can clean up the leg more, or you can completely body clip your horse. It's whatever you like to do with your horse.
Couple last questions here. What kind of oil are you using in the ear?
Baby oil.
Baby oil, yeah.
Yeah. Just, you know, I think when it's no problem to rub it on your baby, your human baby, then it shouldn't be a problem for the horse to have it on their ears or on their coat. What I do if we have like a breeding day, the horses have to show multiple times a day, so you rub on oil multiple times. I do like to clean them off with a nice clean dry towel and take the excess oil off when we come home, just to make sure that it, you know, it doesn't grease up, or you know, it starts irritating or whatever. You never know what the horse feels. So I always like to rub it off and clean it off before we put them back in the stalls.
Do you normally do a full body clip even when they have a short summer coat?
No. When they have a short summer coat, we don't do body clips. Well, it's a personal choice again, of course. But if it's not necessary, you don't do it. It's all just your personal choice. So when you have your four, like right now, this horse is at another stable. And when I go over there and train the horse, it's easier for me to leave behind a dry, clean horse and put on her stable blanket than that I have to put on a cooler and ask other people to swap blankets because I have to go home. So that was a good reason to do a body clip as well. And I wanted to show you, so that was a perfect opportunity to videotape it.
Do you polish the hooves for currings?
We do, everybody does it on their own way. We just use the same polish that you guys use, the ones with a little fluffy thing on the end, or spray cans. And I just heard a question from my left. They ask about the clipping of foals. We do the same clipping on foals, no body clip, but they look more beautiful when you do a body clip. They do prefer that you don't do it, just because when they are out 24/7, and that is usually the case in the Netherlands, and you take off that hair of the foal, it has a reason it's there, on the coat of the horse. So they prefer you to leave it on, but they can't prevent you of body clipping it. But then usually the mares and foals go back in the stable during the night, or stay in when it's nasty weather or something like that. But the ears and the face, we do the same way. If you're able to do the legs, you can clip the legs, or you don't have to clip the legs because there's not that much hair on them yet. But you kind of do clip them the same way as an adult horse.
Great. Great information. Let's see.
I want to add one little thing to the foals. Sometimes you see pictures coming by of foals in the Netherlands. They do have a beautifully clipped face, and it looks nice and black, and the rest of the body is completely in baby fur and brown. The judges don't mind that at all. You just define the face a little bit, and if the body is brown, they don't mind that at all. So, okay.
I think we're going to do a last call for questions here real quick. But while we're kind of wrapping things up, I want to thank you and Doeke for taking the time out of your schedule for doing this. This has been wonderful. Like I said, I know it's really either late or early, whichever way you look at it there. Again, we want to thank the Fenway Foundation for Friesian Horses for sponsoring this webinar. They really know how to support Fauna and everything we do, and we want to continue our relationship with them. This was an educational webinar put on by our education committee, and I can't thank Lisa Baker enough for all of the behind the scenes work that she did in working with Petra to get this organized and put on our educational schedule. So Lisa, I believe you're out there, so thank you, and we appreciate your hard work. Now this was part one of our five-part series, right, Petra? And
yes.
I think we're gonna try for March 31st. Tentatively.
Doeke? Yes. On a Thursday again, yes.
Thursday, yep. Thursday, same time. tentatively, that's what we're going to schedule, unless we'll get this on the books here shortly. But mark your calendars for March 31st. That'll be our part two session.
I will give you the information about what part that is going to be.
Terrific. I know the members will be looking forward to that. So let me just double check the dates real quick for you before we, the last Thursday of the month, which I thought was the 31st, maybe I got it wrong. Okay. Yep, March 31st. No, March 25th, sorry.
Oh, yeah.
March 25th will be the next one, be the last Thursday of the month. Does that still work for you, Petra?
Yep.
Okay, so we'll plan on March 25th, and we'll get this scheduled, and we'll get some rest.
Yes. thank you for having me, and if people have questions ahead of time, well, they send them to you and I will get them from you, and hope I can respond on that and incorporate it in the video. And if it's automatically already comes into the video, it will come by. And
we'll do. Yes, yeah, please send your questions to us at fauna@fauna.com. We'll make sure that they get answered and over to Petra, and you'll get a response shortly. So thank you, Petra. Doeke, we appreciate your time and look forward to seeing you next month.
Thank you, and seeing you next time.
Yeah, take care.
Bye.